In my last video, I showed you this very cute tiny little plant. This is called Fenestraria rhopalophylla, better known as baby toes. And they actually really look like cute little baby toes. Today, I want to talk to you about how you can take care of this tiny little plant. And also, I want to give it a new home. So we are going to do a little bit of a repotting and we are going to talk about how you can keep this tiny little plant happy. This little bowl I also found in a thrift store. I paid 50 cents for it, and this is one hell of a strong little bowl. It took me more than 20 minutes to drill this tiny little hole in the bottom. I would have loved to have a bigger hole, but this was all I could manage. So I decided to put a lot of terracotta pieces in the bottom to make sure that I have good drainage, because this is very, very important for this little plant. Fenestraria rhopalophylla is actually from the same family as Litops, and the best container to use for a plant like this is a container that is quite shallow. And even though this container is quite wide, it is not that deep. So with a little bit of terracotta in the bottom, it's going to be a very nice fit. And I do think it will look very cute together. The best soil mixture to use for this plant is a combination of potting soil, sand and grit, or a very fine gravel. I ran into the problem that I could not find any of those things nearby. I even could not find a cactus soil. So in the end, I decided just to use my normal potting mix. I did run it through a strainer and I ended up, I don't know if you can see this, but I ended up with a very fine and very loose soil mixture, and I really hope that this is going to turn out well. Maybe I will repot it in the future, but for now this is just what I have to work with, and sometimes you have to improvise a little bit, so I really hope that this little plant is going to be okay. This plant, of course, loves a lot of sunshine, so keep it in a south or at least a west-facing window. Also, it doesn't like temperatures any lower than 19 degrees Celsius, so keep that in mind. Do not put this in a very cold room, just give it a nice warm and sunny place in your house. And when it comes to the watering, the internet is saying some conflicting things. I read that you should water this every 2 weeks during the growing season and one time a month during winter, but I actually think that's a little bit too much. Personally, I would wait until it gets a tiny little bit wrinkly and then I know I really need to water it. Absolutely do not soak this plant, because you are going to kill it very, very fast. When it comes to fertilizing this little cutie, you only have to do this one or two times a year. The best time to do this is in spring, around May, and you can give it a second time of fertilizing during summer in August. And you can just use a normal cacti and succulent fertilizer, but the best thing is to dilute it half strength, because this plant is used to very poor soil and probably you are going to shock it when you give it the normal amount of fertilizer. So just neglect this plant a little bit and it will thrive and it will be very happy in your home. This was everything I wanted to tell you about Fenestraria rhopalophylla. Let me know what your experience is with this tiny cute little plant. For now, I just want to thank you so much for watching my video, and I really hope to see you in the next one. Bye!